Okay, so let's put it back together and get it registered. So I'll give you the heads up. I think it's pretty fair to say that if you put Harley Davidson on the front of something, you can sell it for, you know, 10 times more. This lead here and this lead here cost me $60 on eBay. I went to my local car shop and this cost me about $6.50 for this long lead. In other words, I could get a pair of leads going from the coil to the spark plugs for between $10 and $15. And these leads cost $60 plus postage. So I'd just like to thank somebody on sort of preying on my innocence or ignorance. I don't rip anybody off. I certainly wouldn't charge that price. If I could get a pair of leads for about $12, I'd make sure that the person had them for about $35 to $40, not $60. That's just a rip-off and being greedy. So you may remember in the video before this one that this fuel line just sticks up too far, and it has to be brought down to about this level, otherwise it's above the fuel switch there, so this has to be shortened. First of all, in the previous video I did the timing. This is the timing plug here. It's a see-through PVC type of plug. I have to remove that and put the original plug back in. It's not easy to get these plugs in and out. I mean, if the carburetor's not on, then you can get around behind here and actually, you know, screw it. I can just barely reach in, but the back of the carburetor, or the carburetor's knocking on the back of my hand there. If I get around on a real angle, I can just turn it out, yeah. That's with the air cleaner removed. So that's the electrical wire protection they use for a protector for the petrol inlet hose. So that's too tall, that's making that bow up too high. I can cut that off right down to about there and allow the pipe to sit lower. Okay, so das ist besser. So that's a timing hole plug for Evo Sportster, and what I do is I just put some silicone on it so it doesn't leak oil. Okay, so your idle air-fuel mixture screw is right up underneath at the back of the carburetor. So I've got my finger on it now at the back of the carburetor there. Now the best thing that I've found for that is you can get these sort of a set of screws, small screws, if you go to a electronic shop, or sometimes you'll find them in an auto shop. And with that I'm able to come around here, because you've got to do this while the engine's running and this is going to be very hot, so you can come around, operate underneath it, just try and find the screw. So once you located the screw, I can turn that screw now. So what you do is you you seat it, you screw it all the way in, and then until it starts to stumble. So you only screw it in until the engine starts to stumble, then you back it off and you flip your accelerator until you got good response, and you leave it at that. That's your idle air fuel mixture done. So screwing the idle air fuel mixture out makes it more rich, screwing it in makes it more lean.
Whenever I've got a problem, say for instance a great big project I've got to do, a whole lot of work, or an engine that's not running, or a car, a bike, or anything like that, is I just plod along. You know, plenty of time to think. Think during the week, work on the weekend, and just sort of plod along at your own pace, and eventually you'll fix it. What we're going to do now is we're going to find out what main and secondary jet sizes are in a standard carburetor. I think it's standard anyway, it seems to be standard. The main jet, I can't see anything anywhere saying what size it is. No, there's nothing. You know, I've got my glasses on, and there doesn't seem to be anything written anywhere. The secondary jet. I'm pretty sure there was a number on one of these jets. I'm not sure which one it was. Yeah, there's no number there at all. Okay, well, it's running a bit rich. Don't do these up too tight either. That's your air fuel mixture there. When your bike's new, or if the carburetor hasn't been worked on before, you'll have to remove the cover plate to get to the air screw mixture. Screw. Just before I put the carburetor on, I just want to point out something. A couple of videos ago I installed this inlet manifold, and you remember that gasket I bought for it? Well, if I look down there now, you can see that after doing the timing and letting the engine warm up, that the gasket sort of wrinkled around a bit. Now I hope that over the long term it'll sort of shrink back, but you know, really that's not good. We'll check out the other side. You see how it's sort of, the heat's made it ooze out a bit and deform within the inlet manifold there. I don't think the rubber manifold would have acted like that. Rubber won't do that, but that's some type of plastic, and so far I'm a little bit wary of that. So at this point you want to put your VOES ignition advance plug on, put the situate the choke properly, bring it up to the manifold, and attach it to the manifold.